Hi my friends of Good Sound in the Car. Welcome back to the Mosconi Lab to part 2 of our DSP tutorial using DISC. Today we follow the question, how comes the music in the DSP? Let us start. Yes. Okay, I've already connected with my Pico A12. Yesterday we have updated the firmware up to date to the firmware 4.01, and I have, as I told, it's connected. I have connected a source player. You see it, the input level in the DSP monitor. Okay, how comes the music in the DSP? For this we have analog inputs by the Pico line as microfit connector. Pico A12 is a 4-channel analog input, and each input pair 1, 2 or 3 and 4 can switch to a high level or low level. What does it mean? It's very important to decide between high level and low level. For this we have to do a little bit theoretics. Low level or single ended means there is one signal wire, the minus wire, or by RCA connector, the RCA ring is connected to the signal ground. It's flat, no signal. And the hot wire, the plus wire, or by RCA the pin, contains the signal in a positive or negative half wave. This is the normal low level connection, or by single ended amplifier, the output. This is a typical high level connection with a BTL amplifier. By this connection, the signal wire plus and the signal wire minus, so RCA pin and ring, are hot, are contained the signal, inverted by the phase, and it's not coupled to the analog ground. For this, our DSP or DSP amplifier, if you switch from low to a high level, it have to use a different schematic. So sorry for the break, it was the postman. So for this, our input stage from the amplifier have to change the schematic, like from low level to high level mode. In low level mode, the plus wire or the RCA pin is this wire, and the minus wire or the RCA ring is connected by a resistor to the ground, fixed connected. If I switch the input to a high level mode, the ring and the pin are disconnected from ground, and between pin and ring, between plus and minus, is a dummy load resistor switched. This resistor simulates the OEM stereo and connected speaker. By the Pico amplifiers, we have a little slot with pins for a jumper like this. You can put it in, so in this way, and this jumper has two different functions. In low level mode, it connects this resistor between the minus and the analog ground. So if the jumper for this channel is not plugged in, this resistor don't exist, and the analog ground of the Pico is connected by the source ground. In high level mode, it connects this resistor, this dummy load resistor. So if it don't plug in, the dummy load resistor don't exist, and the OAN car stereo can't measure an resistance. Okay. So in this way, if we know our source is high level or low level, we have to imagine what does our amplifier. Now the first important thing after the electrical connection is the leveling of the inputs. In this new GUI, you see the gaining, the leveling of the input by the, wait, I switched to English. The input level you see by this view meters. That should be nearly to the max, but not over the max. High input voltage, but not too high. That's very important. So by the standalone DSPs, I show you. I have an 608 aerospace. By standalone DSPs, you have a gaining pot you can use to match the input sensitivity to the source voltage. And to help you by this, there is a small LED, a clipping LED. If your source voltage is too high, the clipping LED began to flash. I'll show you. Wait. All right, music. You see it. As louder I drive the source, the clip LED begin to flash and shows me the maximum voltage of the input is reached. In this case, you have to reduce the sensitivity by the pot. I'm sorry, I'm a little bit ill today. Okay. So that's for the analog inputs. By Pico A12, it's analog to channel 1, 2 and 3, 4. But each Mosconi DSP also have a digital and an SPDIF input. You see it in the mixer. Input 9 and 10 is SPDIF digital. You see it in the block flow, in the block view. Input 9 and 10, SPDIF digital, okay. In the DSP monitor, it's also channel 9 and 10. And this digital input, each Mosconi DSP device have more than one digital input. We have one as optical, as Toslink input. And we have a digital input pin on the Bluetooth ports. Pico A12 has two Bluetooth ports. So if you want to use an BTS and Bluetooth streaming module, where it is. Here, I have one. I show you. If you want to use the streaming module, the digital input pin from the port is used. For this you have a little switch. You can switch where is my input on the optical, on the card 1 or at the card 2 slot. Break number 2. It's not easy today. It was the Frank from the Eifel. Okay, where we stopped, 3 digital inputs, optical, card 1, card 2, and depend by which input I use, I have to switch, set the little switch. In our case, I show you today, I use the optical input. So wait, I plug in a Toslink cable and I start a little bit music on this cable. Digital output, okay. Let's start a little bit music. So here it is, music is started. I see the signal in the VU media. I see in this digital input pattern my SPDIF is selected by switch and the sampling rate of the incoming signal is 96 kHz. Okay, that's very easy to use by the standalone DSPs, by the aerospace standalone DSPs. 6 to 8 and 8 to 12 aerospace, the selection of the used SPDIF input goes automatic. It means the DSP search one input by the next input by the next input, and the first input where he found a music signal, it stops searching and locks this input. Okay. We have the music in the DSP, we have leveled the inputs. Now we can set the first adjustments. For this I go to this button Delay Gain EQ, it means the input stage Delay Gain EQ. You have for each input pair an input time delay. This is important if you have an OEM car stereo with a time delay. Maybe the left channel is delayed 1 millisecond. You can, with the input time delay, set the right channel to 1 millisecond and both signals, left and right, are synchronous. Okay, at next, you have an input gain. You can decrease the volume on this input pair. It's by the Pico amplifier is very important to match different inputs to the same level. And further, you can remote control this input gain slider, for example by the RC CAN, by the CAN bus module. For this I set a checkbox, and if I set this checkbox, this channel is remote controlled, the input, by an RC CAN module. A third, you have an input equalizer, 9 bands for each channel pair. For channel 1 and 2, for channel 3 and 4, the analog inputs. And the third input equalizer, you can choose where it sits. You can set it on input 5, 6 or input 7, 8 or in our case on input 9 and 10. Then it's an overall equalizer for our SPDIF signal. If you go to the block view, you can set the same. You see the signal way, input 1, 2, analog, over gain, over delay, over EQ in the mixer, also for the inputs 3 and 4, and also for input 9 and 10, my digital input. And here I see the digital input is goes over the gaining and the input EQ 3 in the mixer. If I set the input EQ 3 connection to 7 and 8, you see this in this signal path. From this block view, you can go to the setup side every time. Go back in the block view. Okay, we have the signal in the DSP, we have leveled it, we have done the first settings or explained the first settings. Tomorrow we go to the input equalizer and we will de-equalize an OEM car stereo with OEM equalizer. Thank you for watching, stay tuned, see you tomorrow.